good morning, y'all. How are y'all doing?
Good morning. How y'all doing today? My name is Brandon, and this is my wife,
Tracy.
And we are with Link Church Online Campus, and just want to welcome you today. Yes. Thank you for joining us today on this beautiful Sunday. And thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to just come do life with us. Yes. Choosing us to do life with. Yes. Thank you. So, anyway, hope you had a great week. Look forward to service today. And Tracy,
we have a new series coming.
Yep, we do.
Yeah, new month, new series.
That's right.
Looking forward to that. Yes.
Last month was great. It was powerful. A lot of application there, you know. Yes. A lot of powerful nuggets, I call them.
Yes.
So, Trace, why don't you tell them about the account and the guest?
If you're not logged into YouTube, please tie their offering on there. It's super easy.
Yes.
And then we have, we're adopting families
absolutely.
For Christmas. And
to your home.
Yes, and there's different ways. With us being online, and we're an online community, you can go to the offering and be able to give a donation through that way, and or you can drop a gift off at the church in any way. But those are due by December 15th.
Thank you for being part of that
yes.
as well. So with all the service, you know, it's praise and worship. You know, we enter into the presence of God and just praise and worship Him, giving Him our best, our
yes.
sacrifice. During that time, there'll be an exhortation.
Yes.
Pastor will come up, encourage, and just encourage us. Share us a word, you know, to just speak to us. And so
yes.
I pray that you'll receive that, Lord. Those things are always so great. And then, there'll be announcements. And
yes.
then after that, Pastor G will come give his sermon on the new series this month. So, and then after that,
decree and declare.
That's right.
Woohoo! Decree and declare.
Yeah.
And
so.
Declare those things over your families, your loved
right.
ones, and yourself.
Yeah, so we just encourage you to do
yes.
that. As always, speak it out.
Yes.
Claim it.
Yes.
So, you know, with all that being said, we are going to pray us out,
yes.
or pray us in, I should say, to going into service. So, dear Heavenly Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for this day. And we ask you, Lord, just to, Father, I pray you'll be with each and every person online, each and every person in service. Father, you prepare their hearts to receive exactly the word and message that will
yes.
penetrate their heart, Lord. Father, touch them and bless them today. Father, we love you and honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So, look forward to seeing you
yes.
online. Thank you.
Thank y'all. Be blessed. Have a great day.
That's
See
right.
y'all soon.
Good morning, Link Church. Happy December. This is the month that we celebrate our King and our Savior. Whatever has happened this last week, even at that door, I want you to focus on the Lord today. We're going to praise Him.
Thank you.
wonderful day.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful day, guys.
Hallelujah.
This is the day.
I needed rescue. My sin was heavy. The chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter. I was an orphan. But you called me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you're my healing. Now your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. Cause when you call my name, I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day. You call my
beneath my shame. There's people here who have felt shame from things that you've done in the past, and you can't get past that shame. And you're prodigals. You've known who God is, and you've come back, but you have continued to feel shame, and you're buried beneath it. But our God is so good. He wants you to come out of that shame. Out of that shame. What has been holding you back is the shame, and you can't get through it. I don't care what you've done. Our Lord is standing right there with his arms open. His arms are open. I don't care what you battle with, depression, anxiety, suicide. His arms are open. He's right here waiting to meet you. Your breakthrough is pushing past that shame. This altar is open for you.
There's so many Bible verses that talks about in the scriptures of heaven. And there's some verses that talks about angels, how they worship him all the time. Even talks about how creations worship all the time. But at the Link Church, we worship all the time. I know that everybody here somehow, some way, worships God. Is the greatest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all. All thrones, embassy, all power, and positions. Your name stands above them all. Your name is the highest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all. All power and dominions. All powers and dominions. Your name stands above them all.
How many know that we serve a great God? Nah, don't pity pat God. How many know that we serve a great God? A God that has brought healing. A God that has brought financial restoration for your home. A God that was always there for you. He picked you up at your lowest points. A God that never turned away from you. How many serve a great God? We serve a great, great God. This morning he gave me an image of a mountain. And I said, well, God, what would you like for me to share? And this is the only part that's really not, you don't go over it. You can't go over exhortation. You can't really exhort. You can't really go over and study what you're about to say when God wants to flow. Because then he'll just change it all around. And so he showed me an image of a mountain. Psalm 95, 1 through 5. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it, and in his hands formed the dry land. We serve a great, great God. We serve a God who is above all others. You see, we try and make other things a God. We could make our money a God. We could make our boyfriends a God, our girlfriends a God, our partners in marriage. We can make different things a God, but God says, I am above all of that. We serve a mighty King. There are many that are on their way climbing the mountaintop, but there are many of us that are right there at the peak. And when you're at the mountaintop, when you look back, you can look at the things that were done before, which was something that my sister Kaylin mentioned, shame. You start to feel unworthiness. You start to see fear because you're looking back. But God wants us to look forward. When we're at the mountaintop, we can see the horizon. We can see what is ahead of us. God, I want what's for me in 2024. I want good things. God, I don't want to go through the things that I went through back here. Well, stop looking back. It's time to look forward. You're at the mountaintop. You're right there. So many are at the peak. There are so many of us here that know that there's so much more for us. There's healing. Who wants healing? Who's expecting healing in their bodies, healing in their minds, healing in their hearts? God, I want healing for my marriage. What are you expecting? Is it finances? Is it a son that's lost in the world? Is it a child that you're just praying for? Is it your job situation? What do you want in the forward? Because what you see in the forward, you can no longer look back. We are new creatures. God says all creation cries out. I love this song. Holy, holy, holy is Jesus. Holy is he. He's the only thing that is holy in our lives, because not even we can be as holy. We can strive for holiness. We can strive for perfection. But holy is he. Holy is he. That is what the angels sing in heaven. God, you are holy in this place, my God. God, you are holy in the heavens. You are holy on earth, my God. Help us to hold on to the things, my God, that you have for us, the promises. Let us not lose sight because of discouragement, because of fear. We cast it down now in the name of Jesus. God, we say that we are a blessed generation, God. Lord, no longer looking behind us, but moving forward, all creation cries, holy. Can we just sing that part just a little bit? Holy. All creation cries, holy. All creation cries, holy. Holy are you, God. Holy are you.
All creation.
God, you hear us, my God. Wow. God, you hear us, my God, and you are well pleased.
Holy, you will always be holy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Holy forever.
He's standing up. He's standing up. He's standing up. God, I see it, God. God, I see it. Thank you, Jesus.
Holy, all creation cries. Holy, you are lifted high.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy forever.
Give me some instruments in the name of Jesus. Let us give God just a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Wow. The angels are rejoicing. For my seers that can see, for those that can hear, it's just a beautiful sound in the gates of heaven. Such an anointing flows when we could just sing out. Sometimes in other countries, listen, we don't have the lights. We don't have the drums, the piano. Sometimes they don't even have the voices.
Enjoy the technology, but it's great to figure something out for yourself.
But it hinders, I think, sometimes face to face.
Sometimes coming together.
Like some of y'all did last night, together, fellowship. We miss that camaraderie, fellowship, where we could cry tears of joy together. But in a place like this, you can, because you matter. We're just glad everybody's here. So you're going to get some cards here in a minute as I continue to talk. Just save those for later. They're prayer cards, but they'll be explained to you in a little bit. A little pencil, so we can fill those out when that time comes. And know that you guys matter. I also get the opportunity to talk about tithes and offering. Yes, tithes and offerings. But here's the spin on it. It's between you and Jesus, just like your relationship. You do with your bag what you want. But out of a cheerful heart, honoring God for his love for you. And it's not that he's left us. It's that we've turned our back on him, and he's right there waiting for us. I'm almost 14 years sober from alcohol. And here's the thing. Prior to that, I did not listen to God. And I walked away from him. Sometimes I ran away from him. But I think he's faster than I am. I was a little kid watching Speedy Gonzalez. I think he's a little faster than that little mouse, Speedy Gonzalez. You know what I'm saying? Because he wouldn't leave me alone until I just turned around and said, you got me. And then I started walking it out, because normally we don't like looking at ourselves and say, hey, we're part of that problem. But Jesus is right there for you. So your tithes and offerings, everything we do here, we serve the community. We serve you. Pretty soon we're going to talk about the Dream Center on the 9th of December, serving people and children. So God is good. Who you with? Come on, y'all got to wake up. So there's different ways to send in your tithes and offering. You can do it on, or through your phone, text 45777. through that first initial setup, you'll set it up, set in that monetary amount, and then after that, it's already set up on your phone through that. You can also use these lovely envelopes, and we have boxes in the sanctuary and out in the hall where you can fill it all out, and you'll get a reply for taxes. So use the blessing for a tax write-off. You can mail it in to 3141 Northwest 10th Street, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, 73107, a linked church. And we also have these wonderful folks here who are going to pass the buckets. And no, it's between you and Jesus. And yes, do we need monies to turn these lights on and keep them going? But here's the reality. My King Jesus, his bank is bigger than that. He wants you to have a relationship and honor him with everything and not keep that plastic card as an idol. Because many times it says insufficient funds. So hopefully that's not the case, but let's be real, right? So what are you holding on to the card for? How about some peace and joy in your life? So we'll just pray over the offering, and then we're going to have an awesome thing coming up next. So Lord, watch over the tithes and offering. Watch over our relationships with you, Lord. Let us gain an understanding and a revelation that this holiday season is because of you. It's because it's you in our life, and we accept the love that you give us. Let us be good stewards over everything that comes in from here or online or through the mail. And we love you, Jesus, so much. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's give. 3, 2, 1, give.
Good morning, saints. How y'all doing this morning? So I just want to give a breakdown on this really quick. I'm going to let my beautiful lady give her the honor to do the introduction of everything and the passing out, since she actually picked up the baton on this as I've been dealing with some personal things. But I just wanted to give a breakdown. We get to honor some amazing people today on our School of Deliverance today. This will be our second year that we get to complete this and do life with people. This is what we believe at the Lean Church, for people to grow in the knowledge and the relationship of our Lord Jesus Christ. So if you've completed the School of Deliverance, will you please start making your way up here, por favor? So just a quick breakdown, and this is just what I'm going to do. I want to break it down to give y'all the understanding really quick what we do. So it's 9 classes, and we do it through Zoom because it is important for us to make sure that y'all obtain the knowledge and get involved. So whenever we talk about deliverance and the School of Deliverance, you know, a lot of times the first thing that's going to come into mind is casting out demons. We already know that, especially with the YouTube videos and everything. But it's more than that. It's more in the classes that we break this thing down to help y'all grow in your relationship and your knowledge with our Lord Jesus Christ. Because a lot of times as hearers of our salvation with our Lord Jesus Christ, we don't really understand what comes with that. So through these classes, through the 9 classes that we break down understanding Luke 10:19, the authority that you have in our Lord Jesus Christ, understanding your identity in Jesus Christ, understanding the courtship, understanding who God is as a supreme judge and how to approach him, and understanding different prayers as well, because in the book of Revelation, it teaches that there's an accuser trying to accuse the brethren day and night. So we teach y'all about this authority and how open doors take place, and learning about repentance and confessions and renunciation prayers, and knowing who you are in Christ so you can walk out your salvation. Because throughout the whole New Testament, it talks about walking blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So this is what we do. We take a lot of areas. We break down 1 Thessalonians 5:23, understand that we are spirit, soul, and body. We focus on that area. We focus on, you know, being planted and rooted in Jesus Christ, John 15, and Psalms 1, knowing that apart from him, we cannot produce anything. So this is what we like to do and help y'all understand this, and being able to approach God properly, being able to stand, and not just that, above everything else, being able to walk out your authority in Jesus Christ, because there's going to be family members that reach out to you, and we might not always be available. Our pastors might not always be available. But y'all have the same Jesus inside, the same Holy Spirit to lay hands, to rebuke, send things to the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ and to send things back to the abyss where they belong. Y'all don't have to always rely on somebody else. And that's what we try to train people up. And that's what we believe here at the Lean Church, to empower you through the Holy Spirit. Everything is done through the Holy Spirit, so that way you can understand the power that's in the blood of Jesus Christ. So I'm going to let my beautiful lady get the opportunity. Huh? Oh, my fiance. Let me correct myself on that.
Just saying. I had to, babe. So it's an honor to be here today. So excited to honor these people that, you know, showed up and learned. I want to say that deliverance is for everybody. Whether it's you being delivered so that you could be rooted. You know, sometimes all we need is to accept Jesus as our Savior and receive a deliverance. And that's all the rooting you need to continue on your path. I always tell people that when you have people that, you know, start serving the Lord and they accept Jesus as their Savior and things like that, we all go through moments in our life where we're vulnerable and the enemy takes advantage of that. And that's where deliverance takes place. Because if you, you know, start serving God and there's still things where you're like, what is going on? Like, I'm doing everything right, you know? But it's because you may need deliverance. And deliverance is just breaking ungodly things that might have happened since you were a child. There's just so much involved. So deliverance is for everybody. And we also all carry the anointing of deliverance. So when you're equipped to deliver, you can deliver your loved ones and set them free. And you don't know if that's what it's going to take, you know, for that preacher to come out, that prophet to come out, you know, that worship leader to come out. My fiance is a perfect example of what deliverance did for his life. You know, his walk with the Lord started off with deliverance. And here we are now. God's given us the honor to be able to honor these people.
Just one thing. You don't have to join the ministry of deliverance. Remember, it's the ministry of Jesus Christ. But we just want to make that for y'all to know. It's just for y'all to obtain the knowledge, to grow in the knowledge. Y'all don't have to get involved in the ministry. We want to help y'all in y'all's walk with the Lord.
And to piggyback on that, deliverance is a tool that we have in our spiritual toolbox. That when we need it and we're out praying for someone, you have that authority to be able to cease whatever it is that they're battling. So I'm going to read Luke 10:19 is a scripture that we stand on. And I'm going to go back a little bit to Luke 10:17-20. It says, the 72 returned with joy and said, Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name. He replied, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the powers of the enemy. Nothing will harm you. However, do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven. This scripture is so powerful. You know, Jesus is letting them know, like, I saw Satan fall, which means he's already under our feet, because God did that on the cross. And the word authority is very important when you're walking in Christ, and your identity in Christ is very important as well. Authority means the power or right to give orders, make decisions, and enforce obedience. So your identity and your authority in Christ is crucial to your walk with the Lord, and it's very important that you know who you are in Christ and that you get into your word, and the Holy Spirit will reveal that to you. Then you'll start to receive this deliverance anointing, even for yourself. I mean, when I was called, God delivered me first by myself, crazy in the living room. And I was like, oh, my gosh, Jesus, take it out. I didn't even know what I was doing. And here I am now, you know, 15 years later, and God has anointed me to be a deliverance minister. So with that being said, we're going to honor today. Can I have Miss Tisha Rose, please? Okay. Miss Ashley Rivera Rodas. Mr. Alex Rodas. Miss Gigi Martinez. Adrian Rodriguez. Liz Rodriguez. Erica Delgado. And Miss Kaylin. Congratulations. So God placed in our hearts to do a prayer of impartation over you. So we're going to do that right now. Okay. Right. I want to thank you guys. And this is the beginning of great things. And I just pray that the Holy Spirit continue to reveal to each one of you just everything, all the gifts that we have, the callings that we have, you know, the anointing that God has placed within us. You're a very special group. There's so much I see. And all of you carry that gift very heavily. Do not fear. Do not fear is what the Lord is saying. You have all authority. Don't let anything make you tremble, because God is God and He created everything, and everything bows to Him. And we carry that authority. So I'm going to go ahead and start praying. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you honor and glory today, Lord. Father, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, the blood of Jesus, God, I declare and decree, Heavenly Father, special anointing, Heavenly Father, over Kaylin, God, over Erica, Lord, over Liz, Father, over Adrian, Father, over Gigi, over Alex, God, over Ashley, Heavenly Father, over Tisha, God. Lord, that the Holy Spirit just fall upon them, Heavenly Father, God. Lord, that the impartation, God, and the anointing of deliverance, Heavenly Father, fall upon them, Heavenly Father, like they've never experienced before, God. Lord, that wherever they go, Heavenly Father, as they speak, God, people will be delivered, Heavenly Father, for your own honor and glory, God, that people will come to your feet, Jesus, because of their testimonies, because of the word they may give them of encouragement, God. Lord, I declare and decree in the name of Jesus, God, the authority of Christ over them, Heavenly Father, to trample scorpions, Heavenly Father, to trample, Heavenly Father, everything that's of the enemy, God. I thank you, God, for the lives, Heavenly Father, Lord. And I thank you, God, for the amazing things that you're going to continue to do in their life, God.
Dear Lord, we just thank you right now for this group, Heavenly Father. We thank you right now. We give you the praise, the honor, and glory to be able to complete the second year, Heavenly Father. It is all through you, my God, that this was possible. Right now, we just pray a double portion over them, Heavenly Father. Same way with Elijah was with Elisha, Heavenly Father. We pray that over them right now, Heavenly Father, that everything that you have for them, Heavenly Father, will come up in the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father. The boldness, the truth, the anointing, Heavenly Father, will flow like rivers of living water, my God. So right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bless their journey, I bless their walk, and I pray that you will continue to use them for your kingdom and your honor and your glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. You guys give it up for the School of Deliverance one more time. Come on, y'all can do better than that. That's awesome that you guys take the opportunity to take your walk to a next level. Listen, I'm telling y'all that this faith walk is so much more than just a Sunday service. Y'all believe that? Right? Coming to church is just part of it. And some people are like, well, you don't need church to go to heaven. That might be true. But the Bible says, never forsake the gathering. We do life together. And when you're down, somebody can help you, just kind of lift you up just a little bit. Right? And so we get to do this thing together. But I'm telling you that drawing closer to the Lord is what's going to get you into a deeper relationship with God. Listen, coming to church doesn't get you closer to God. Your discipline of what you do Monday through Saturday is what draws you closer to God. Amen? How many of y'all believe that? Right? And so next week, we have the School of Ministry, individuals that have been trekking for 10 months, right? It's 10 assignments, 10 books for 10 months. And next week, they get to graduate. And so this thing is kind of, how many of y'all have ever seen the movie The Matrix? Right? There's the blue pill or the red pill? In January, we will offer you one of those. How far do you want to go? And you make a determination. And so you could be ankle deep. You could be knee deep. You could be waist deep. Or you could be all the way in. But you got to decide, and only you could decide. Amen? And so not part of the message, but I'll just go ahead and go there since I'm already kind of heading that direction. And so the year of 2024, how many of you would agree that 2023 has been a weighty year? Has it been a little heavy? Some people have dealt with relationship stuff. Some people have dealt with financial stuff. Some people illness stuff. And so for the year of 2024, the Lord has given me a word, and that's the word go. That's the word go, because there's too many things, or there has been too many things that has been holding us back. And we got to get to a place where we realize that we got to remove all of the barriers that have been stopping us from going. How many of y'all have had a tough year and you could attest to that? Right? 2024, we got to get to a place where we say, devil, listen, I know that you're trying to hold me back, but God has greater for me. Amen. And so you got to believe that. But listen, we got still 1 month to go. So don't be thinking too much into 2024. You got to get through this 12th month of the year. And so don't get so far ahead that you miss this month. We got some business to take care of. Amen. And so this entire month, we will start on the sermon series, A Story to Tell. All of the decor that you see here that is wrapped up with nice, pretty newspaper is not because the Link Church is in financial struggle and we can't afford wrapping paper. It's on purpose. We did it with the intention of A Story to Tell. And oftentimes when you're trying to read something from your community, we have Google now. But at one point, it was the newspaper that someone threw in front of your door for you to figure out what's going on in your community. There has been a story for many, many years before Jesus, about Jesus, and even after Jesus, of the soon-to-return Jesus. And so there's a story to tell. There's something for us to cling on to. In the month of December, somebody say December. December. All right? That's the month that we're in case you want to know, right? And so I have been focusing heavily, my wife and I, to be present in the month of December because, again, we're so task-oriented that we can always be so far ahead that we miss what's right in front of us. So we are intentionally trying to become engulfed of this holiday season, right? How many of y'all love the Christmas season, right? Y'all like the pumpkin spice latte? See, some of you, we're like a divided crowd. They're like, I don't know if it's pagan holiday. It's not a pagan holiday. We're going to get into that today. Y'all don't even know if y'all to raise your hand. Should I like Christmas? Should I like Christmas? Can we agree that this is a day that the Lord has made? That we can rejoice and be glad in it? I'm going to let you know what my family does in the month of December. We try to be all festive and all of that stuff. We enjoy this time, and it's an opportunity to bring honor even in a greater way to the name of Jesus. Right? And so we are doing all that we can. My wife even went, she went Christmas shopping. She went and bought. We give all of our kids stockings on Christmas Eve. All the kids, they get to open it. Because, you know, kids start begging you to open up a gift like 2 days before. And so we appease them. And so we give them stockings. And we cook dinner on Christmas Eve. On Christmas Day, every man for themselves. I don't care what you got going on. Listen, we're honoring baby Jesus by not cooking in the house. And so at the beginning of the month, you know, they're older now. And so if you have a bunch of small children, or if you have small children, I'm just going to give you, there is hope. There's hope. When they're younger, it's all about quantity of gifts, right? They want a bunch of gifts and their list is long. As they get older, it's quality. The gifts are more expensive, but they're less. Amen? And so don't worry. If you got little ones, there is hope. Later on, you get to buy them less. For now, there's this amazing store called Five and Below. Just buy a bunch of that stuff. Just buy a bunch of it. And so we would get a list from our children, and we would look for all of the sales, and I have the better of the deal between my wife and I. My wife takes care of the entire family. I just got one person, Bill. That's it. And sometimes I don't do the best at that. And so I try. I'm like, babe, help me to make it even more the more special for you because I'm cheap, y'all. I'm cheap. She said, yes. She's heckling me. But all in all, we do all that we can to be that for somebody else. My family, before we ever indulge in the holiday of Christmas, we've always made sure that we were making it special for somebody else. There were times before we moved here to Columbus, Georgia, we planted our first church in Columbus, Georgia, and we did a bunch of outreach events. And one year, by the grace of God, we partnered with a shoe store. And they gave us 200 plus shoes to give out into the community. We did an event, and I would, like, we didn't say, you know, 10 size 8s and 5 size 7s. No, literally, we would call out a size, and everyone in the room got a pair of shoes, and we gave a pair of shoes to over 200. I got pictures online to prove this thing. It's amazing. We were able to celebrate with others and being able to just use an opportunity of a confused holiday, whether pagan or not, to be able to just serve people and allow ourselves to cling on to one of the pillars of our faith. And what is that? To take care of the widow, the poor, and the orphan. In our household, on Christmas Eve, we eat, but before everyone opens their stocking, we pray. And then Christmas morning, the kids are ready. They're ready to open up before they used to wake us up. Now they all want to sleep in, so they don't care what time we get up. And so before we open, before we exchange any gift, what do? We pray. And we say, God, thank you that we know that Jesus was not born on December 25th, but we thank God that he was born. And that a Savior has salvation has been offered to us, right? There was a period of time where there were things that had to be done, and the Gentiles did not have the option. It was only the God of Israel. Now we have this awesome opportunity to call Jesus our Lord and our Savior. Isn't that amazing? I know. It's not about the gifts. Somebody say it's not about the gifts. I want to break the back of religion. I'm going to believe that deliverance is going to happen in the mind of some people that hold this thing bound to a religious belief and stop themselves from understanding that every day belongs to God. Can I give y'all a few little known facts? How many of y'all in this place have said TGIF? How many of y'all afraid? Y'all don't know what to think right now. Monday through Thursday, how many of y'all at work say, I can't wait for this weekend? Right? Can I let you know this tidbit of fact and information? Every day of the week is named after a Greek god. So if you said, I can't wait till Friday, in essence, if we want to think like we think about Christmas, we're saying, I can't wait to celebrate the Greek god of Friday. Is that what you're really saying? Monday is the lunar god. Tuesday is the god of war. That's why y'all angry on Tuesday. I'm just kidding. I just made that up. That ain't even true. Wednesday is the god of power and wisdom. Thursday, the god of thunder. Friday, the goddess of love. Saturday, we were talking about this earlier, and Gigi had made a statement about people showering on Saturdays. How many of you have ever heard that statement, right? Like, oh, it's Saturday, I took a shower. Do you know where that came from? That came from this Greek god of Saturday. Saturday was named after the planet of Saturn, and it means hot tub or bath. And so that's why some people are like, oh, it's Saturday, so I'm going to take a bath. That means that you bathed in honor of your Greek god. Or Sunday, the goddess of Norse mythology, the sun goddess. Let me mess it up for y'all, because y'all here in Oklahoma, and when I lived in New York, I didn't see this. Nobody celebrates their birthday for a month long like they do in Oklahoma. You Okies love to celebrate for a month long with the, I thought somebody was like, they were hungry. That's why they had a pin with money on it. I was like, I'm trying to give to your lunch. No, they want my money because it's their birthday. And so the origination of birthday, it's actually birth is a Greek god. And the Romans began, they originated this thing, and they believed that as the lunar became a part, the lunar system became a part of our calendar, then they realized that as we mark another year, that opens the door for an evil spirit to come and attack our life as we become 1 year older. And so individuals would offer half of a cake to this lunar god. And you know how we're running around trying to find candles? Who got the candles? I like the ones that you blow them out and then they turn back on again. Y'all like those, right? Yeah, this is why people would light up those candles. It was for protection and to ward off evil spirits. And so if you are confused about any holidays, but you celebrate a birthday, you are a pagan worshiper also. And so we get so caught up and so bogged down about systems that the reality is that you only have half the information. Half the time you're trying to not worship or worship one thing, and there's so much distraction that in other parts of your life you've been worshiping it all along. Here's the deal, y'all. Listen, the Bible is clear when it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31 through 33. They do not have it. They're probably scrambling up there and be like, we messed up. No, you didn't mess up. I added it this morning. You're good. I feel the eyes. It says this, and I read. So whether, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31 through 33. Listen, y'all jot this down, write it down, keep it in your hip pocket so that you could use it in future to come. Amen? All right. So whether you eat, y'all just go, because it's not up there. Y'all ain't got no Bibles anywhere in your hands. So whether you eat, or drink, or whatever you do, do it for the glory of God. Whether you decide to celebrate December 25th or not, if you're going to do it for the glory of God. If you put up a candy cane all over your house, whatever you decide to do, do it for. If you want to buy me a gift, do it for the. But here it goes, hold on, because I want to be fair. It says, do not cause anyone to stumble. So if you don't celebrate it, don't get at me for celebrating it. And if I celebrate it, I'm not going to come at you and be like, look at you, you religious stiff neck. No, I'm going to mind my business. You do what you want to do and what the Spirit of God in you provokes you to do. But we cannot serve as a stumbling block to one another. I believe and I want to serve people, and I'm doing it for the glory of God. Can we agree to that? Yeah. Google is one of the worst things that could have ever happened. Why? Because some of y'all got some Google degrees. Y'all a doctorate in Google. And half of y'all just stop at the first bit of information, which is Wikipedia, and you can't trust that. And surely if you are stopping at every prophet that's on social media with their little cash app afterwards, that they ain't nothing but naysayers. And we got to be careful what we bring ourselves to. Before all of this social media, half of y'all didn't know what was going on anyway. So why? Listen, it is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Whether it be Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday or Thursday or Friday, or whether it be January or February or March or April, God is the God of all of it. And let me explain something to you. There is no time in the place of eternity. Before anything ever existed, there was a God. And in the midst of it all, we can't understand the infinity of who God is. And if we could, then he wouldn't be God. Why? Because what you was going on in between your ears is too big for you to be able to fully capture all of who God is. So if you can't understand it, it's all good. You're in good company. Me neither. Can we agree to that? Because when we look at our lives, there's originations to things. There's all kinds of stuff and how it got started. There was a family that I knew that every year they would cut the butt of the ham, and it was a good piece of ham. In the Puerto Rican household, we use ham. We put in the rice, arroz con gandule, jamón. And they would throw away this piece of ham, and I'm like, why y'all do that? That's good food. Give it to me. I could do something with that. Un sopón de jamón. Y'all don't know what that is, but I'm going to let you know it's good. And I began to ask them, why are you throwing away that good piece of ham right there, that sustenance? Why are you throwing that away? And nobody could tell me why. It's just something that they always did. Then the uncle came marching, and you know that uncle that everybody got? Diana's cracking up over here. He said, the reason why we throw it away is because we didn't, back in the day, we were so poor, we didn't have a pan big enough to cook the whole ham, so we had to. And it became tradition. See, some of us, we do things and we have no idea, but because it's, you see someone else doing it different than you, you say they're doing it wrong and you're doing it right. What if weird was the way, and the people we call weird are the right ones, and we're the ones that are? See, as believers, and I learned this lesson from somebody that's actually in a room. They said, this is what we do as believers. We all get together in a holy huddle, and we point the finger at the people with the sin that we're not dealing with. It's a day that the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice. I'm going to let y'all give me a gift. And I'm going to give a bunch of gifts because that's what the Lord has instructed my family to do. See, there are individuals that has never seen the countenance of a child's face when their family cannot afford to give them a gift. And if your heart can be broken by the view of that, some of us really wouldn't be so stiff-necked about it. When a child is seeing the rest of the world celebrating, and it's so much more at that moment. See, the Bible gives us some clear instruction, and we're so good at the first part of this instruction, and that is to love the Lord thy God with and all of your... And all of your, and then it says, and the second of these is to, woo, there's not a whole lot of people that knew the second portion of that scripture. Because we're really good at loving the Lord thy God. Well, half we say we're doing it, but we really ain't. The second part of that scripture is to love your neighbor as yourself. And so how can I love God and not love his creation and put that in the same sentence as being a believer of God? Listen, if you're going to love God, you better love his creation. If you're going to love God, then you got to love that your neighbor as... See, my wife and I, we were looking, we're like, do we even know our neighbors? I don't know. I know them my neighbor's name because our dogs are always barking at each other. But how can you say you're broken by the things of God, but not broken by what his people go through? Love the Lord thy God with all of your heart, all of your strength. That's found in Matthew chapter 22, verse 36 through 38, if you're taking notes. See, if we read the story of the nativity scene in Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20, it's an amazing story. I could sit here and read to you all 20 verses of this thing. And every time we hear the nativity story, it's an amazing story every single time. David goes home because they were doing a census. He goes home to the town of Bethlehem. On the way, Mary is ready to give birth. All of the rooms at the inn were taken up, and they're just trying to find a place for Mary to have this baby. What do they find? They just find a barnyard, a barn house. And that's the place where they decide to have baby Jesus. See, Jesus came lowly. He didn't come as a king as everyone expected him. He came lowly. There's so much theology as to him being laid in a trough and being swaddled up. But the amazing, some of the amazing parts of this story, we stop at the baby Jesus scene, right? We stop at the little manger story, but there's some other things that happened. There were some angels that went to the nearby neighbors and were saying, hey, listen, baby Jesus was born, and they all got excited. They all of the neighbors, they began to spread the word, and they began to look for the manger, for the barn house. Can you imagine an angel comes to you and you own this barn house, and all you hear is that baby Jesus has come and he's in a barn house. You're running out to see if he's in your barn. Like, Jesus? We got a bunch of ethnic folk in the house. All y'all nosy. Y'all be like, it's Jesus? It's amazing, this story. There are three things that this story builds up on the inside, and the three things that I want you to capture on today is that through time, before Jesus was born and since he has been with us, three things that we should carry with us along the way, and that's anticipation, preparation, and expectation. The book of Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah, he says this in chapter 7, verse 14. It says, therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. The prophet Micah in chapter 5, verse 2 says, but you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be ruler in Israel. And so it wasn't new. Like, the people during that time, it wasn't like they were living and they didn't know Jesus was going to come, that the Messiah was not going to be upon them. There was an anticipation. There was an expectation that was always on them. And therefore, they lived with preparation. They would send a priest in to make her do make things right for everyone. There were people that were reading all of the Torahs and the religious writings, and people coming together, and they all believed that this Messiah would come. The problem is that he didn't come as they expected. He came lowly. But they were active in their preparation, much like we are in our time today. You came to this place. You put some change in the offering bucket as it went by, or maybe through a text and church app. You serve at this ministry, and you don't do it because I'm so cool. You are actively in preparation because Jesus is coming again. There's an anticipation. We are anticipating that Jesus will return again. We are expecting Jesus to return again. We are living in preparation. That's why when we come to God, we try to sin less. Although we may never achieve becoming sinless. See, the enemy distracts us with the minor things. We major in the minors. Maybe Jesus was not crucified during Easter, but he was crucified. Maybe Jesus was not born on December 25th, but he was born. And what greater opportunity do we have to sit and honor and bring honor to the Savior, to the one who is and was and is to come? He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. COVID changed a lot, but one thing he did not change was our Savior. We can cling on to it. He is consistent. He is constant. He is committed. He holds you up. And even when you grow weary, my God is never weary. He never sleeps. He never slumbers. He's always on time. Listen, that's the God that we serve, and we become so divided as to whether we should celebrate Halloween or Easter or Christmas that we forget that God is the owner of it all. God owns it all. Now, we do have to be mindful And we can't allow these little demons to come into our house because we've opened a door to them. But so often we get so caught up in fighting more demons than celebrating the fact that we already won. There's victory in the name of Jesus. And we get so caught up in our small battles that we forget that the back of the book says that we already won. I try not to get myself caught up in all of the mess and the hogwash of people. There are people that got more vision for your life than you got for your life. I don't need you to give me any more ideas, boo. I got ideas that will change the world. What I need is your provision. But whether you give it or not, God is going to make it happen. Why? Because God is the creator of the heavens and the earth. And whether you decide to do it or not, God will find an available vessel. December 25th is a day that the Lord has made. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. And not allow the enemy to try to steal from the people of faith. Do you realize that witches, warlocks, all those folks that we're like, oh, those folks look at us and they laugh. We are the only people. Witches ain't fighting against one another. Christians are. You don't ever hear about a demonic church divide. How many church splits have you been a part of? Why? When God, all of this belongs to God. All of it belongs to God, and God just gives us an assignment. It says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the light. There is no other way to the Father except for me. It is a narrow path, but there is a path. Can you walk that journey through and forget about all of the things, all of the noise? There's a lot of noise, would you agree? There's so many ways. There's so many ways to accomplish this and do that and get here and go there. The reality is that there only is one way, and while you have a way, there is a way. There is the way, you have a way. And if somebody doesn't do it your way, it doesn't mean that they're wrong. See, when I make my pork shoulder for any holiday, I become the cooker of the pork shoulder and the big birds and all of that stuff since my brother is on the road and all of that. And I could give you my recipe. And some of y'all that are cooks be like, that ain't the way, this is the way. But when y'all eating the way I make it, y'all smacking your gums. You enjoy the way that I made it. Just like I enjoy the way that you make it. But there is the way. See, during this time, there's a Latin word called Advent, or in Latin, Adventus. Have you heard this is the Advent season? Well, the definition of Adventus is the coming. And you may not like the term celebrating baby Jesus during the month of December. Maybe we can change our terminology just a little bit. And we can celebrate the coming. He came once and he's coming again. We can celebrate that. We can gift exchange on the fact that there is an anticipation and a preparation on the inside of us that Jesus will return again. He came on the back of a donkey once, but he's coming on the back of a white horse with a sword in the sky, and he's going to bring his church home. We can celebrate that. On December 25th, you don't have to say, happy birthday, Jesus. You can say, I'm celebrating you're coming again. Because that day is a day that the Lord has made. And we can. I don't care what you got going on in your house, what's happening, whether you're having a good day or a bad day. We can celebrate that it's a day that the Lord has made and we can rejoice. We can rejoice. And as you're doing it, listen, what greater way or a greater day to be able to express being the hands and the feet of Jesus. See, some of us get so caught up in the whole holiday in such a selfish way that we forget that God still sent us. And the Bible says, beautiful are the feet of those who go and bring the good news. So I remember early on, my daughter's not here today, but I remember she used to leave cookies and milk out for Jesus and her Bible so that he could autograph it. I could never bring it to myself to sign the Bible on behalf of Jesus. I tried many times, and I was like, I'll go to write that thing. I'm like, blasphemy! I'm telling y'all the truth. That's the truth. But I eat them cookies and that milk, though. Let me ask you this question. What is your expectation of Jesus returning? What anticipation do you have of Jesus returning? See, some of us, we're at a place where like, God, I got too much to do. Don't come back yet. Some are expecting a baby, right? And they're like, I just want to see my baby. God, don't come yet. I want to see my child. I'm just starting my life, God. Don't come back yet. But here's the reality. How amazing would it be the day that the clouds split and the trumpet blasts and Jesus is coming down ready to receive his church? Listen, I don't think that there is anything greater than that moment right there. But yet we become so divided on a day, a moment, a holiday. Whatever you do, may it glorify the Lord. Whatever you put your hand to, may it glorify the Lord. Sunday is like the new weekday for kids that were in school. Kids Monday through Friday all have belly aches. Sundays, all adults have some reason, some pain, something that crept up over them overnight on why they can't come to church. We're divided on minor issues when the reality is that there's 365 days in the year. We're hyper-focused on one, and the other 364, you ain't doing right anyway. And I said you, but I meant we. Because all of us can do better. Now, we may look at some sins greater than, like, oh, look at what they did. Oh, look at their behavior. Oh, look at that. Like, baby, listen, you better turn that mirror. Turn that thing right around. I love my iPhone, but if you got an Android, they all do this. You see, it has a camera that has the stovetop of five cameras looking out, but there's one that can look back. Some of us need to look at our reflection and say, I know that there's confusion. I don't know, potato, potato, whatever it is, tomato, tomato. But there's something greater that we can be giving our attention and our time to. But we become so raw, even to the point of ruining good relationships. I've always heard this, never have a conversation about faith or religion with people because it'll bring a divide. Paul told Timothy, don't involve yourself in foolish babble. If you don't believe what I believe, I'm not going to sit and have a conversation with you. You could call me whatever you want to call me afterwards, but I'm not going to convince you otherwise, so why waste our breath? You believe what you believe, I believe what I believe, and can we agree to disagree? But I want to still love you, and I still want to be friends. Some of us are willing to take it to like, reality is this. Was Jesus born? Was he born of a virgin? Is he the Son of God? Was he 100% man, 100% God? Did he bring salvation to the world? Is it worth celebrating every day of your life? So I mentioned earlier in Luke chapter 2, we get to verse 8 through 12. I love this portion. Because we know the nativity scene, but I wanted to concentrate on these few verses as I close. And it says, starting at verse 8, and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock. They had their own thing going on. They were at night. It was at night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. Verse 10, but the angel said to them, don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger. So this is a message. The angel is going around to all of the little places. He was kind of like the telemarketers do when they had to walk around the neighborhood knocking from door to door to door to door to door, bringing a message. Then we get to verse 16, and it says, so they hurried off, meaning the farm keepers, the land keepers, the landowners. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. So they were nosy. They went to confirm for themselves first. When they found what they heard had happened, they saw it. Then they went off and did what? Verse 17, when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told them about this child. You know where we get stuck? On whether who's right or wrong. But I know that everyone in this place is better because they've come into contact with Jesus. You heard about the good news. You heard a message that there is a way. You heard that you can go to a place and there is a way to break through your depression. You heard that there is a way to break through addiction. You heard that there was a way for your marriage to be restored. You heard of a way for your mind to be in the right place. You heard. And you were afraid and you were like, listen, I tried so much in my life and you're telling me that there's a way to break free from this stuff? You mean that there is access to something that can change the dynamic of my life, that can change the narration of my story? It hasn't been good up to this point. I grew up in generational poverty. I grew up in dysfunction. I watched my mom get beat. There's been times where there was lack in my life and we needed the finances. And you mean to tell me that there's someone that can help me? You mean my heart can be healed and my mind can be healed? You mean that there could be healing in my body? That means that there's healing past the force, that there's healing past the issues and the chaos of my life, that there's someone that can help me? We went and looked. And we found out that the story was true. And some of us, there was a moment in time that the person that was spreading this message made an opportunity to come and line up at an altar and say, listen, there is this someone that can help you. And you run up and you're like, I need this Jesus. And I pray that everything that everyone has been saying, that this is it. All of a sudden, you make your way. You lift your hands, and like the Bible says, if you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and all of a sudden, something begins to happen. Something begins to change upon your life. And as you walk the journey out, you see that everything that everyone has been saying was true. The problem is that y'all keep coming to this place, and you don't continue to tell others about what you've come into contact with. But yet we become so divided in here that we forget to tell people about Jesus. Has anyone in this place ever been touched by Jesus? Has anyone in this place ever been healed? Has anyone in this place hit rock bottom? And if it wasn't for the Lord, where would you be? Some of y'all headed in the wrong direction towards destruction, but if it wasn't for the name of Jesus. Some of y'all had everyone against you, but all of a sudden you came into contact with Jesus and you contracted the Jesus fever, as Pastor Bill would say. Listen, have you come in contact with him? Because our job is not to divide. Our job is to multiply. How do we do that? We convince the others around us that today is the day that the Lord has made. We get to rejoice. It might not be a good day in definition of your terms, but you woke up this morning. God ain't done with you yet. So as you live your life in this season actively anticipating, expecting, in preparation. Because the God who came and offered salvation to us is the God that will return. And it's not if, but when. See, the Bible says this, that even the rocks will cry out. It makes me so sad sometimes. And I want to chime in on some arguments, because you got some like Facebook gangsters. Soft in real life, but y'all talking all over Facebook. It's so tempting sometimes, because I'm so confrontational with y'all. Y'all don't understand. That's my face, like, delete. Why? Because there's so much more good that we can have our focus on. Y'all look amazing today, by the way. Can I tell you that? Thank you. I showered today. It's Saturday. Oh, Sunday. It's Sunday. My bad. You guys are so amazing. I want to tell y'all. And I want to let you know, listen, you made it to the 12th month of the year. Listen, some of y'all are like, well, I never finished nothing. You're about to finish a whole year. And if you're older than 3 years old, you live through a pandemic, y'all. You may not be all the way there, but you're somewhat in your right mind. You came here, and some of y'all keep showing up to hear me preach. Good news of Jesus. You still have an amazing future ahead if God tarries. But live knowing that what you're doing every day for is for a higher cause. And nothing is worth going to hell for. But there's nothing that I should allow to cause a divide. And so I love you. However you decide, you don't want to put up a Christmas tree at your house, then don't. You want to put up candy canes, you want to whatever it is that you decide to do, but what you do, may it glorify God. May it glorify God. And do it knowingly. Because sometimes, and I don't mean this in a negative way, but we do things ignorantly. That means that we just do it unknowing, and then we don't research it, because it's like, if I don't know, then I can't say whether I'm wrong. Shame the devil. Some people say, well, this is a tough message to preach. The pastor got to get up there and tell us whether it's a pagan. No, listen, I'm bringing word. I'm just teaching you the word. But we can't allow ourselves to come to a place of divide. Ultimately, my message is, let's love Jesus. And it's just another opportunity to do what he has called us to do. My wife and I, we make it our goal every year to serve people. Where we, the little angel tree, we're sponsoring the kid out there to make sure that they have an amazing Christmas. We sponsor all of the kids. The children of the directors of the ministry will buy them gifts. Why? Because we just want to serve people. We're givers. We're generous. I said I was cheap earlier. I am, but I'm cheap so that I could be generous. See? See? I don't overspend in one area so that I could be generous in another area. What? Somebody say they love Jesus in the house. Just tell them, I love you, Jesus. Come on, you could do better than that. Jesus, I love you. And he loves you back. He loves you back. And so this is what I want to do. I want to take the opportunity. You should have gotten one of these top five cards. Everybody get one of these top five cards? If you didn't, just slip up your hand and we'll make sure that you get one. We do this three times a year. Three times a year. And so we have our Christmas event that's going to happen December 17th. Right? The children are going to do a little presentation. The youth are going to have a little presentation. And then we have a choir, y'all. You should come. Sam, stand up, sir. Stand up. Y'all give it up for Samuel Segun. Obi, stand up, sir. Obi, stand up, Obi. You guys should just come to hear them sing on. Esteban is on the choir team. Esteban, just wave right there. Just wave. He ain't. These amazing men partnered. I don't know who else, but it's so unique that these individuals got talked into being a part of this. Come so that you can see them sing. That's going to be amazing. Love you guys so much. And so these top five prayer cards is this. I want you to write down the name of five individuals, if you know that many. If you know three, it's all good. If you know one. But we want people that you write on this, we're going to pray for them all month long. And we're going to believe that December 17th, they're going to come here and they're going to hear the gospel. Now, if you write down the names of people that already attend the church, this is what will happen. They'll come during our event, and then they'll go back home to their church. We want unchurched people. Why? Because we want to do life with people. We want to love on them. And so your neighbor, the people at Walmart that you see that you connect with, your family members, your aunt, your uncle, as Samantha Zavala would say, invite your mama and your mama's mama on December 17th so that they could come and fellowship with us and have an awesome, awesome time. Amen. And so can you take about 3 minutes and just write down these names? And this is what I want you to do. I want you to bring the cards to the altar and just lay it right here, and we'll have our prayer team pray over them. If you could take a moment in time. If you need a pen, there's some pens over this way. So God, I pray in the name of Jesus that all the names that are being written down on these cards, if you're watching us online, just, you may not have one of these top five prayer cards, but just write down the names of individuals that you'll share this live feed to, that you'll invite them to hear the gospel. So as you write these names, be intentional. The awesome part of this is that I've had individuals that maybe they didn't come during the event, but like 3 months later saying, Pastor, you're not going to believe this. The name that we wrote down, they didn't come for Easter, or they didn't come for Christmas, but they're here, and I've been praying for them for 6 months, for a year. I've heard it over and over and over. Listen, this is just a great opportunity and an excuse for us as a church to pray for your family, to pray for your children that may have lost themselves, to pray for a mom or a dad that may not know Jesus like you know Jesus, a spouse. Can you write those names and then just begin to bring them here to the altar once you're done? Somebody break the ice and just bring it to the front. You want to take the lid off of that, Diana, and then we'll put the lid back on. There you go. Thank you. Just make your way. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise God. We're going to continue to take up names all month long. But how many of you believe that, like, you need Jesus, your family needs Jesus as well? Amen. And so extend your hand this way. Can you do that real quick? Father, in the name of Jesus, all of these names that have been written on in this box, on these cards, Father. Father, we pray that as we are writing their names in act of faith, Father, as a symbol, Lord, may you be touching their hearts there while we're praying for them here. Father, we believe that, Lord, that you are an omnipotent God. You are an omnipresent God. You're everywhere at all times. And so, God, even before we make the invite, extend the invite, God, may you already be working on their hearts. Father, we believe that salvation is for everyone, regardless of where they have been in life. God, we believe that you are desiring to live in their hearts. Thank you for being in our hearts in this place. Father, we together will continue to do all that we can to honor you. With every head bowed, every eye closed, and remain in this place. If you're here today and you're saying, you know what, you've been talking about this Jesus and how other people need Jesus, but I need Jesus. If that's you, would you slip up your hand right where you are? If you've never received Jesus, but today you want to make that decision, is there anyone here that would say, today I want to make Jesus Lord and Savior of my life? Is there anyone in the house that would be bold enough to raise their hand and say, today I want to make that salvation? Thank you so much for raising your hand. Is there anyone else that would say, you know what, today I want to make a decision to make Jesus Lord and Savior of my life? It'll be the best decision that you make. Don't put off tomorrow what you can make happen today. Is there anyone else that would like to raise their hand? Maybe you're here and you've accepted Jesus, but you've fallen away and you're like, man, I keep getting distracted and I keep just falling in my own mess. If that's you, just slip up your hand, and today you're ready to rededicate your life. I see that hand right there. I see that hand. I see those hands. Let's repeat together. Dear Jesus, today I accept you as Lord and Savior of my life. Forgive me of my sins. Forgive me for sinning against you. But today I'm making a decision to turn completely from my selfish ways and walk according to your will and purpose. In the name of Jesus, amen. Hallelujah. Can we give God about 3 seconds of praise in this place? We will be praying over these names all month long. And so make sure that as we do our part, that you do your part, and that's inviting them. Amen. And so we love you guys. Bless you. Thanks so much for allowing me to deliver this message to you today.
Amen. So I'm going to do the announcements really quick since we're at the end of service. On Tuesdays, we have our youth at 5:30 right here at the Link Church. So if you have a middle school or a high school student, please bring them out to the youth. Our youth pastors are some wonderful people, and they just love on those kids so much. We have so many different areas here at the Link Church that if you are not a part of a family group, we have many different family groups. We have women's groups, men's groups, couples groups, married groups, recovery, and young women and young men groups. Please get involved. If you do not know anything about those groups and you want to learn more, go to the Connections booth. We have what is called the Tree of Hope. So Pastor G was talking about that we are sponsoring different kids. We have a tree out there. There's still 3 names left of children that we would like to bless with 2 gifts this year. And so if you aren't, maybe you don't want to go out and buy gifts. I'm a woman that don't like to shop. But that's okay, because I really don't like to shop. So I'm one of the people, I'm like, here, just take this money. Y'all can do all the shopping. That's a whole lot easier for me. And that includes my kids. I give them gift cards, so I don't have to do it. And so if you would like to give, if you can always just go to our Link Church website, and you would just go in to fundraiser, and you're going to click toys, and then you just put in toys so that, and then you're a dollar amount, and that will go directly to the Tree of Hope for a kid this season. Remember, it's 2 gifts that we want to provide for these children. We would like the gifts. If you have already picked names or a name or a family, we would like those gifts to be back here by December the 15th so we can give those gifts to the families on December the 17th, which is our holiday event. on December the 9th, so that will be this coming up Saturday, we're going to have an outreach at the Dream Center. The festivities will start from 12 to 4, but we're asking for 20 volunteers that will come out and meet us. It's going to be, we would like the volunteers to be there at 10 a.m. so you can get directions on everything that's going on. But if you would like to be a part of that, Pastor Bill, if you could raise your hand, please go see Pastor Bill to get more information, or you can go to the Connections booth. December 10th, so that's next Sunday, we'll have the School of Ministry graduates. So if you are a part of the School of Ministry, or maybe you don't know what the School of Ministry is, every year we have, it's a 10-week class or a 10-month class, and you read a book, and then you write a report on that book. And so we ask, you know, anybody that is interested in School of Ministry, it will start back up again in the new year. If you would like to get more information, go to the Connections booth, or you can come find me, and I'll let you know about that. But that is going to be next week. December the 17th is our Christmas program. Pastor G already told y'all everything that was going to happen on that Sunday. But just come ready, you know what I'm saying? Bring y'all family in them, and then bring them kids, because I know y'all want to see y'all kids do all that singing and stuff. Bring them on out. Listen, it's a good time. I love being able to fellowship with all people. Just letting people know there's hope in this season. There's so much that people forget about, and they only focus on the gifts, but there's hope. That's what we want to give people, is hope in this season. We have our prayer wall back there in the back. If you would like to put your prayers up there in the back, we have several areas here that you can serve in here at the Link Church. We have our connections team, our media. We have the kids church, who is always needing hands. But listen, if you don't like kids, don't go down there. I'm just saying, that ain't for you. I've been down there. You got to have patience. If you ain't got no patience, like I don't have no more in this older age, you know, just leave that alone, because it ain't for you. But that's okay. We love on them. That's all that matters. But if you would like to serve in the Link Church, we have Next Step cards. They can just fill out, and you give them up there. If you are a first-time or a second-time guest, if you can please raise your hand. We want to acknowledge you. Give it up for our first-time guests, guys. Yes. If you have not already been given a first-time guest card, we would like for you to fill that out, and we have a gift for you. Give it up for them again, guys. If you are online and you are a first-time or second-time guest, give us a one or a two. We want to acknowledge you as well. Guys, we love you. We appreciate everything you do. You walking through those doors is a blessing. You walking through those doors, you have just given somebody hope. You have given yourself hope. You have given yourself something new. You have decided that I want something different for my life. And so thank you for walking in this place today. Our motto here is, why do life alone? And so we want to do life with you. You don't have to do it by yourself. And now let's welcome Pastor Oscar. He's going to do our decree and declare.
So if y'all could please stand at the end of service, we love to do our decree and declare that was amazingly prophetically written by our pastora. And, you know, just believe it. Don't just say it. Believe it. And then I just wanted to make a public announcement to our brother Victor and sister V that y'all have a certificate coming. Pastor Bill will be giving it to y'all. So we love y'all, and we continue to pray for y'all. So just follow us on this decree and declare, our online guests as well. I declare that I am a child of God, and that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. I declare the Spirit of God to manifest in my life daily and in the lives of my loved ones. I declare lost souls will be found and saved with the help of God's people. I decree and declare I no longer live in fear, but I walk by might in Jesus' name. I cast out all substance abuse and dependency. I depend on Christ alone. Anxiety, fear, stress, panic attack, and pain are completely out of my life. I am healed of my past and all sicknesses. I come against the enemy's tactics. God has a plan and a purpose for my life. I decree and declare that I am blessed. My family shall be blessed. My finances are blessed. My bills are paid, and I am current. All curses formed against me are broken. I am living in victory daily. I am a living testament, and through me many shall come to Christ. I decree and declare my life back to God. I am a child of the living God. My plan and my purpose are revealed to me this day. In Jesus' name, God bless y'all. Have a blessed week.